Greetings, enthusiastic viewers, and welcome to this week's Cinema Scene, featuring three beloved animated classics produced by Walt Disney Animation Studios, Aladdin, The Little Mermaid, and 101 Dalmatians. Aladdin, directed by the Academy Award-nominated John Musker and Ron Clements, was released in 1992 during a film era known as the Disney Renaissance. It is based on the famous story Aladdin's Wonderful Lamp from the legendary book 1001 Nights, a collection of Middle Eastern and South Asian stories and folk tales by various authors, translators, and scholars over the span of many centuries. The delightful animation Aladdin is filled with memorable music by 8-time Oscar-winning composer Alan Menken, the noted lyricist Howard Ashman, an Academy Award, Golden Globe Award, Tony Award, and Grammy Award-winning lyricist Sir Tim Rice. The rich story and beautiful animation tell the tale of a young and homeless Aladdin, who is voiced by Scott Wanger. Set in the fictional Arabian kingdom of Agrabah, Aladdin's only friend is his trusty monkey companion, Abu. Aladdin, though charming and kind-hearted, lives in poverty and must manage to get bits of food in order to survive. He fantasizes about living in the royal palace, where he would never have to take what is not his or worry about going hungry. Meanwhile, in the palace, Princess Jasmine, voiced by Linda Larkin, dreams of just the opposite. She is weary of being compelled to marry a prince whom she does not love and wishes to go outside the castle walls. One day, she escapes the palace to explore the streets of Agrabah and encounters Aladdin, with whom she has an instant connection.
You better be able to pay for that.
Pay?
No one steals from my cart.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I don't have any money.
Thief!
Oh, please, if you let me go to the palace, I can get some from the Sultan.
Do you know what the penalty is for stealing?
No! No, please!
Oh, thank you, kind sir. I'm so glad you found her.
I've been looking all over for you.
What are you doing?
Just play along.
You, know this girl?
Sadly, yes. She is my sister. She's a little crazy.
She said she knew the Whoa. Sultan.
She thinks the monkey is the Sultan.
Oh, wise Sultan, how may I serve you?
While the two youths are getting to know each other, the Sultan's Grand Vizier, Jafar, voiced by Jonathan Freeman, dreams of being the ruler of Agrabah and having ultimate power. He uses one of his contraptions to learn that Aladdin, because of his purity, is the only person that will be able to enter the Cave of Wonders. Jafar longs to find the genie's magical lamp that is supposedly hidden within the cave. He orders his guards to have Aladdin detained. While being held, Aladdin meets an old man who leads him to the Cave of Wonders. Little does he know that the old man is actually Jafar in disguise, who instructs him to fetch the magic lamp. In the cave, Aladdin and Abu are joined by a magic flying carpet and find the seemingly insignificant lamp. But as Aladdin rubs it clean, a charismatic blue genie, voiced by the Oscar-winning actor Robin Williams, emerges from the lamp. The genie reveals to Aladdin that he will be granted three wishes, which can be nearly anything he desires. Aladdin, who is smitten with Jasmine, asks to be made a prince in order to sweep her off her feet and marry her. As he begins a new life as a prince, which he thought would give him everything he wanted, Aladdin starts to learn that riches are not enough to impress Jasmine, and that wealth does not necessarily lead to happiness. Aladdin has to use his street smarts, the genie's wisdom, and the help of his friends to stop Jafar from taking over Agrabah. With unforgettable songs like Friend Like Me, A Whole New World, and Prince Ali, as well as lovable characters that ultimately just want the best for their friends, Aladdin has something uplifting for viewers of every age. Through remarkable storytelling, the animation is a timeless reminder that the values of life are hard to measure, and that ultimately helping others is the best way to help oneself. Aladdin won 22 awards, including the 1993 Academy Award for Best Original Score and Best Original Song. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. Cinema Scene will be back with more Disney classics right after these brief messages.
That's where we'll be.
Thrilling chase.
A wondrous place for you.
Welcome back to Cinema Scene. Our second movie today is The Little Mermaid. Also directed by the acclaimed duo John Musker and Ron Clements, The Little Mermaid is a 1989 film based on the Hans Christian Andersen fairy tale of the same name. The movie tells the coming-of-age fable of Ariel, voiced by Jodie Benson, a 16-year-old mermaid princess who would do anything to be part of the human world. It also features Oscar award-winning music by Alan Menken and Howard Ashman. Ariel is a mermaid and the youngest daughter of the Sea King, King Triton, voiced by Kenneth Mars. She is fascinated with the culture of those who live on land and keeps a secret treasure trove of objects from above water that she discovers with her fish pal Flounder, voiced by Jason Marin. Ariel often brings her newly found items to the ocean's surface, where she asks the absent-minded seagull, Scuttle, voiced by Buddy Hackett, to tell her more about humans.
Yeah, I got an aesthetically pleasing configuration of hair that humans go nuts over.
A dinglehopper.
However, her father will not tolerate her talk of the dangerous fish-eating humans and asks the court musician Sebastian the Crab, voiced by Samuel E. Wright, to chaperone his daughter and make sure that she never goes above water again.
Each little slug here cutting a rug here under the sea. Each little snail here know how to whale here. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we in luck here down in the muck here under the sea.
Disobeying her father, Ariel, followed by Flounder and the reluctant Sebastian, travel again to the surface to look at a ship on which people are celebrating the birthday of Prince Eric, voiced by Christopher Daniel Barnes. When a sudden storm arrives, Eric almost drowns after rescuing his dog, but Ariel rescues him and brings him to the beach. Eric awakens in time to hear Ariel's beautiful singing. However, he is only able to catch a fleeting glimpse of her before she quickly dives back underwater. Ariel is clearly head over fins for Eric, but King Triton is furious. Meanwhile, the octopus person Ursula, voiced by Pat Carroll, takes advantage of Ariel's vulnerable state to use her in a plan to overrule King Triton. She convinces Ariel to give up her voice. In return, Ursula will transform her into a human for 3 days, during which time she must win Eric's love. Ariel and her animal friends rally together to do all they can to prevent Ursula from taking over both the sea and the innocent mermaid's soul. Featuring vibrant art and songs as Part of Your World and Under the Sea, The Little Mermaid is an unforgettable tale. It is a story about cherishing all life and freedom. The Little Mermaid won the 1990 Oscar for Best Original Score and Best Original Song, as well as 9 other awards.
La 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 la, by your by, look like the boy too shy, ain't gonna kiss the girl. La 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 la, ain't that sad, ain't it a shame, too bad, he gonna miss the girl.
The final feature today is 101 Dalmatians, a 1961 production directed by the acclaimed Clyde Geronimi, Hamilton Lusk, and Wolfgang Ruthermann, with music by Academy Award-winning composer George Bruns and Emmy Award-winning Mel Levin. Based on the novel The 101 Dalmatians by Dottie Smith, the film was produced by the legendary Walt Disney himself. 101 Dalmatians is narrated by our hero, a Dalmatian named Pongo, voiced by Rod Taylor. The story begins with Pongo and his human companion, Roger, voiced by Ben Wright as bachelors in London, England. Roger, a songwriter, is content with their lifestyle, but Pongo is bored and decides it is time that they find partners. Sure enough, that day at the park, they meet Perdita the Dalmatian, voiced by Kate Bauer, and her caregiver, Anita, voiced by Lisa Davis. Both humans and dogs fall in love and marry. Time passes and Perdita becomes pregnant with 15 little Dalmatian pups. The wealthy and villainous Cruella de Vil, voiced by Betty Lou Gerson, wishes to buy the puppies for her own selfish reasons. But Roger and Anita will not let her. Cruella decides to hire people to dognap the puppies. Pongo and Perdita thus use the twilight bark to sound an all-dog alert after their babies are stolen. The word reaches a rural farm where an old sheepdog, a horse, and a tabby cat find that the puppies' lives are in danger, along with the other 84 Dalmatians that are being held at the nearby DeVille place. Using their wits and the generous aid of their fellow animal friends, can Pongo and Perdita bring the pups back to the safety of their London home? Through a tale that interweaves love and adventure, the film conveys the merits of charity and teamwork. Moreover, it shows a solid stance against the cruel fur industry while highlighting the nobility and altruism of our treasured animal co-inhabitants. Aladdin, The Little Mermaid, and 101 Dalmatians are three meaningful and entertaining Disney classics for the family that exemplify animation at its best. Marvelous viewers, it was a pleasure having you with us for today's CinemaScene. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television for Vegetarianism, a Noble Way of Living. Up next after Noteworthy News, may compassion and creativity fill your days with inner peace and happiness.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/cs.